Audible? So, I guess many of you are still joining. So, let us wait for some time. So while we are waiting for others, you can share your experience so far with me, how the course is going on, and if you have any query or curiosity about anything, you can ask me the questions here. So how is the teaching going on in this semester? Are you enjoying, particularly in this ML course? So we have still just a few lectures on, right? So only 3-4 lectures have been done. And do you have any particular queries or questions related to machine learning from what we have discussed so far, or from what you might have heard from internet or from your friends? Anything? Okay, so Shail is asking, is Alpha Zero a machine learning example? Okay, so I also need to search what is Alpha Zero. Okay, so Alpha Go or Alpha Zero? I have heard of neither. Is it some gaming? I just click search told me that it is some chess game or something. Though. Okay, Chanel is giving me a link of Alpha Go. Okay, so I think both of you are right. Alpha Zero and Alpha Go, both are powerful chess AI. So it is AI, definitely. Definitely it is AI. Within AI, whether it falls under the category of ML or machine learning or deep learning or classical AI or neural network, that we do not know. So it depends on what kind of underlying algorithm they have used. But yeah, there is definitely AI, yes, that is part of the AI. Okay, so let's begin with our discussion now. we said that from now on we'll start discussing algorithms. We spent two lectures in the introduction of machine learning, and we have seen like mostly the algorithms that we are going to talk about will be classification, clustering, and regression. And I believe Varalakshmi madam has started with a regression algorithm. I will start with a classification algorithm. There are so many classification algorithms. Out of those, we will begin with a very popular, very intuitive, and a relatively very easy classifier known as naive-Bayes classifier. We'll see what is naive-Bayes classifier, why it is used. So outline for today's discussion would be introduction, a motivating example, and this is a probabilistic classifier grounded in Bayes rules. That's why the name naive-Bayes classifier. So we'll talk a bit about Bayes rule and naive assumption. Then we'll formalize this notion of naive-Bayes classifier, how it works, with an example, and then we'll conclude. This might go on for next lecture also. So within a couple of lectures, we will finish this discussion. So, to give you a perspective of what we are talking about a class of classifiers. We are talking about classifiers which are known as probabilistic classifiers. So, quickly, let's go through some simple Wikipedia definitions. So, classification is a task of assigning. Okay, Canon says voice is not coming through properly. Let me check the network. Canon says, okay. So classification is a task of assigning. Yes, it's my problem, but it breaks sometimes. Okay. So is it good now? Okay. So classification is a task of assigning different labels to objects. For example, a librarian classifies books into different genres like drama, fiction, non-fiction, etc. Right? So in library, when we visit a library, books are arranged into different classes or categories. Computer science book, mechanical book, electronic book, and so on. Similarly, library can also arrange book in different genres. Library may also arrange book based on author. So all these are classification activity. So we have this habit, human have this habit of compartmentalizing everything. So even if you have a cupboard, you have different classes to place different things. One section for your clothes, other section for your accessories, and so on, isn't it? So we do this all the time. Grouping similar things, put it in a single class, and it helps us doing our day-to-day chores. So a classifier is a machine learning algorithm used to assign a class label to a data input. For example, an image recognition classifier label, an image. For example, car, truck, person. So you are given an image and you need to give them a label, whether it is an image of car, a truck, or a person, and so on. So this is what we are going to discuss for most of our semester. Up to one session or one and a half session, we will be talking about classifiers. And for now, for next few lectures, we will be talking about probabilistic classifier. A probabilistic classifier is a classifier that is able to predict given an observation of an input, a probability distribution over a set of classes. So instead of putting something into one class, for example, instead of saying that this is a car or a truck or a person, it would say that this looks like a car with a probability of 70%. This looks like a truck with a probability of 40%, and so on. So it learns an entire probability distribution over a set of class. We will see what that means. But before that, a funny example. So when some creative instinct occurred, I come up with this funny cartoon. And what is this? What does this look like? Oh, cat. Wow. So most of you got it correct, right? So, or I don't know correct, but most of you find that it looks like cat. Okay, so I showed it to many people and people were of different opinions. Most of them say cat, but then some say it is monkey, others say it is squirrel. So what I do is, after this, what I do is I put a label there. So I have asked 100 people, out of 100 people, 60 of them say it is a cat. Thirty say it is monkey, and 10 say it is squirrel. So what I say is 60 by 100. My confidence in answer is this: 30 by 100 and 10 by 100. So probability of this thing being cat is 0.6. Probability of this thing being monkey is 0.3, and probability of this thing being squirrel is 0.1. Right? So we can do this kind of thing, isn't it? Given different answers, we can come up with some estimate. So what we have done is, the point that I want to make here is that instead of saying concretely that this is cat or this is monkey or this is squirrel, I am attaching a probability count with my answer. So this is what I mean by this phrase. A probability distribution over a set of classes. So a probabilistic classifier, let's read that sentence again. A probabilistic classifier is a classifier that is able to predict, given an observation of an input, a probability distribution over a set of classes. So we have three classes, cat, monkey, and squirrel, and it is given a probability distribution over those classes. And observation of input, what is the observation of input here? Let's try to finish that also. Everything will be concrete. This is our input observation. We looked at this cartoon, and based on that cartoon, we have created a probability value for different class labels. If we are doing something like this, then we are working on probabilistic classifier. I will pause for few seconds, or half a minute, and try to get this in your mind and ask me if you have any questions on this. Any questions? Is this all clear? Okay, Kewal says, is probability distribution considered as an input to algorithm? It's a very good question. Before that, I think most of you understood what we are talking about. Kewal, it is a very interesting question. So Kewal says, is probability distribution considered as an input to algorithm? Answer is, algorithm will learn this probability distribution. We want algorithm to learn the probability distribution. And based on the learned probability distribution, we want algorithm to make predictions like this, as I have just shown here. So you have seen so many cat, monkey, and squirrel in your lifetime that you could very confidently say that this is cat, right? So all the past instances of cat, monkey, and squirrels that you have seen in your life played a role in your making this decision. Your mind was trained for that. Similarly, we want to train machine to recognize this thing more confidently. Bhavik says probability distribution judge with SAT score. Not now, Bhavik. We'll talk about this once we reach there. For now, let's try to keep the thing simple. Jainil says that, so if we want to predict, will the algo just say it is CAT because it has high probability? Yes, things like that, yes. But why CAT got high probability? That is what the learning of algorithm is all about. How much probability will be assigned to CAT for a particular input? That is what we want to learn. Am I making sense, Jainil? Okay, sir, isn't this data given input by us? Okay, so it is not the data given by us, okay? Yeah, so Jainil, your questions, this is an interesting question, and this will require some context. Yes, Jainil, you can unmute and tell me.
Hello, sir, am I audible?
Yes, I can
hear. Sir, what I am asking is, sir, in this, sir, we are just giving the data that n number of people said cat, some said monkey, and some said squirrel, and it is just calculating the probability. So how is it learning? Means,
so that we'll see that once we talk about the algorithm, we'll see that. But so that is what we'll see in next one or two lectures.
Okay,
but for now I want you to be clear that whenever you are giving an answer, you are attaching a probability value with that, then it is a probabilistic classifier.
Okay, sir. Right? Thank you.
How does it happen? That we'll see. But then there is a deeper question also inside this general question, that if it is just calculating probability, then why it is machine learning? Can't we say it is just a probability calculation or a statistic? Same old probability calculation that we used to do. What is learning in this? So also keep this in mind. It is very good to begin our discussion with this kind of question, so that the rest of the things that we are going to discuss will give you more insight. So keep this question in your mind. So if it is just counting numbers and calculating probability, where is learning, or why it is intelligent? This is the more deeper question that Jainil wants to ask, isn't it? And I will not answer it immediately. We'll look at this for one or two lectures, and I anticipate that it would be automatically clear to you. But once we have done with the basics of naive-based classifier, I will come back to this question. And remind me if I forget to come back. Right? So let's see what happens. So as they say, all that glitters is not gold, isn't it? So what is gold? So let us try to develop a classifier that can identify gold. And for that, we have used two features. Some feature one is color. Is the color golden? Then we say yes, no, and so on. Second feature that we are using is it glittering? And based on that, we will answer whether it is a gold or not. So that is our class label. As you know, features are also known as attribute. I can also write A1, A2, and class label. So this was A1 divided by F1 or something like this. So let me make it completely different. Let us call this. X1 and X2, and let me call this class label Y. What's the direct capital? So So our feature set or attribute set is we are working with two features, X1 and X2, and class label. Y. If you want to remember its value, I can write values in bracket also. So this X1 and X2 are actually golden and glitter. Then class label is actually, is it a gold or not? And how many examples or instances are there in our data set? Okay, most of you got it right. All of you got it right. Jenny says 4, but otherwise everyone says 5. Number of okay, Jenil says yes and yes are 2 times. That is allowed, Jenil. So 2 same answers would be counted as 2 separate instances or 2 separate data sets. Otherwise, it cannot be data set of size more than 4, isn't it, with 2 features. But if I am asking, as I say, in that cat example, I have asked 100 people. So here also I have shown an object and asked 100 people. Is it golden? Answer is yes. Does it glitter? Answer is yes. Is it gold? Answer is yes. And so on. Right? So if I ask 1,000 people, then I can have 1,000 examples. If I show 1,000 different objects to same person, then also I get 1,000 examples. Okay. So this is our basic setup. Based on data, first thing we do is we calculate how many features are there, or not calculate, but we see how many features are there, how many class labels are there, how many examples are there. So from now onwards, whenever a table is given to you showing some data like this, you should be able to figure out this thing, features, class labels, example, and so on. And now from this, we want to get this probabilistic answer. In this previous case, the probabilistic question we asked was probability of this animal equal to cat, probability of this animal equal to monkey, and so on, right? This is what we were trying to figure out. So what probabilistic question we are asking here in this gold example? The question that we are asking is probability of gold is equal to yes given some value of golden, let's say golden is equal to yes, and some value of glitter right. So our machine tries to make predictions like this. What is probability of something to be gold if it is golden and if it glitters? So based on our observations, so these two are observations, And they are also known as, they are also called predictors. Jit says 0.5. Okay. Jit, don't jump to the calculation. Please be with me for some time. What you calculated is correct, but whether we really want to do it or not, that is a separate thing. So please be with me. It might go a bit slow in the beginning, but that is good to spend some time on basics. So please be with me and get the terminology clear. So golden and glitter are observations and predictors. So predictor means the things that we, that helps us in making our prediction. So that is observations or predictors. And this is class that we want to predict. Right? Are you with me so far with the notation? Okay. So what we want to do is, if I want to put it in terms of x, y, I want to calculate probability of y given x. So I'm observing x. So this is part of observe. This is part of predict. So you are looking at x and you are predicting y. And as we have discussed in earlier introduction lectures, relation between y and x is not so simple that you can directly write a function for y. Right? So this is our setup. And whenever we are making prediction, we want to attach a probability value with that also. So that's why we call it a probabilistic classifier. Yeah, so let's go ahead with the formulation. For that, we need some basics of probability. Have you heard of something like joint and conditional probability? Okay, good. Most of you have. So when I was taking offline class, many of you were not aware of that. So anyway, let me write this. So whenever you're modeling a probability of two events, A and B, you have two options. Right, so what do you mean by probability of A and B? Probability of observing both A and B. In machine learning language, we write this as probability of A comma B. These two are same. And I think in your probability classes, 12th standard or 3rd sem, or from wherever you recall, this can be calculated in two different ways. One way is this probability of A into probability of B. And another way is, can anyone answer this? I'm just curious whether you know this or not. Keval says, okay, great. Yes, Keval. It is probability of A given B into probability of B. Or equivalently, you may also write that it is probability of B given A into probability of A. Right? And out of these two formulas, which one we use depends on how these variables are related. So if A and B are independent, then you use this, right? And if A and B are dependent, okay. then you use this. So you see that whether variable A and B are dependent or independent. And what do we mean by a dependent variable and independent variable? Or before that, I should also clarify that what do we mean by variable here? What is X and Y here? Or what is A and B here? Same notion of probability, we call this, what kind of variables are there? What is named for this variable? Events, but in which events some variables are attached, and those variables are called random variables. So A and B are random variables. They are dependent if outcome of one variable or value, if outcome of one event. So two events are, let's talk about in terms of events, since many of you have answered in terms of events. So two events are dependent if outcome of one event influences outcome of another event. Then they are dependent. So if it rains, then I will carry an umbrella. So event of raining and event of carrying umbrella are dependent on each other in a way. Right? But if it rains, and what? Nothing is independent of rain or what? I was just trying to find out something independent of it. So if it rains, can you give me some example of independent word if it rains? If it rains, I will sleep at night. Or okay, if it rains, I will study. Yes, that is also good. Kaushal says. So you study, right? Independent of raining. It doesn't influence by raining, particularly when you are studying from home. So independent variables, so you got the point, right? Independent variables are those where value of one does not influence another. And dependent variables are those where value of one influences another. Okay, so that's the story. So let's quickly see whether these variables are independent or not. Let me again name them. So we have three variables, x1, x2, and y here. And how many of the are your questions are x1 and x2 independent? What is your comment about x1 and x2? Are they independent or dependent? Okay, most of you say they are independent, right? Because something can glitter even if it is not golden. And something can be golden and not glittering. So they are independent. Okay, good. And what about X1 and Y? Golden would always glitter, right? They are dependent. So X1 depends on Y, I guess. If someone tells you that I have some object, some ornament of gold, and then ask you, will it be glittering? You say yes. So probability of X1 to be true given Y let's say yes is equal to 1. So probability of X1 is equal to 1 given Y is equal to 1 is very high, right? So Kaushal has exactly given the relation dependent and outcome of X depends on outcome of Y. So if you know Y, you can very easily answer for X1. Same goes for X2 also. So X1 and Y, X2 and Y are dependent. Good. So we have reached to some basic of probability that we needed to know. and which gives us this very famous rule. What is the name of this rule? It is Bayes' theorem, right? Bayes' theorem, which is a simple manipulation of these two formula. So for a set of dependent variables, we can write this thing. This is called Bayes' theorem or Bayes' rule. And we will use it to answer our question of probability of y given x. As Kaushal has answered, x depends on y. And if it is golden, then we can, if it is gold, then we know it will glitter. So the dependency that we know is probability of x1 given y and x2 given y. And prediction that we want to make is opposite of that, y is equal to x. Okay, Bhavik says, what if two features are dependent? So we'll see that case also. When the features are dependent, the computation would be more complex. So we will start with simpler computation, and that's why we are saying that the features are independent. Janan says EDA. What is EDA? No, but why are you typing EDA? Is it related to what I have asked something, or you want to know something else? No, generally, I think I have lost the context. So why this EDA and data analysis? Okay, we can drop those which have high. Okay, so you are saying that you are answering Bhavik's question, I guess. No. So don't go there. We will see the case where features are dependent, but not for now. For now, our example says the features are independent. So let's talk about that. But the point which I want you to realize is that we want to find out answer for probability of y given x. Right? We want to find out. We want to find out what is the value of y given x. This is our goal. But the dependency is towards x1 and x2 depends on y. So the value we have is probability of x1 given y and probability of x2 given y. Right? So do you see there is a flip required? You want to flip from y given x to x given y. And this flip is possible because of this Bayes' theorem. That's why we are introducing Bayes' theorem here. And that's why the classifier that we are talking about is Bayesian classifier. So let's spend some time on this. We want to find out A given B. What we have is B given A and B. Right? So this is very simple and very basic slide of this network, which you all need to know. But also, please pay attention to this thing, because this will go a long way. So please ask me if you have any questions on this. Intuition should be clear. So let's break down this Bayesian equation into the machine learning terms that we would be referring more often. So probability of A is what we already know about A. And that is called classifier. prior probability of the class A that we want to predict. Similarly, this is called predictor prior. Predictor, these are predictor variables. So what we already know about features. It's called predictor prior. And this is likelihood of, this is probably the most important part of the discussion, is the likelihood of a feature given the object. So if you know the class, what will be the likelihood of the feature? That is called likelihood. And this is called posterior. The probability that you get after looking at the prior probability. So prior multiplied by likelihood is posterior. So prior and posterior means, prior means what you already know from the data, what you already seen in the data, and put it in your machine, and whatever you get as output will be your posterior. So is the nomenclature clear? Any question on this? Okay, good. So I think it is clear to most of you. So these are the things we need. So we need to know like to make prediction, we need to know this. Without these values, we cannot make any prediction or we cannot do any calculations. So how do we know this? How do we know what is probability of A, what is probability of B given A? So let's see here. So if you look at this data, can you calculate probability of gold is equal to yes? What is probability of gold is equal to yes here? 3/5, right? And what is probability of data is equal to yes given gold is equal to yes? Bhavik says 0.2. So says 1. Okay. So there are 5 cases where gold is yes. Not 2/5. So glitter is equal to yes given gold is equal to yes means, look at only those examples where gold is yes. Right? Glitter depends on gold and gold outcome is fixed. So denominator here will be 3. Because there are 3 cases where gold is yes. Right? And out of these 3 cases, in one case glitter was yes. So glitter is yes given gold is yes is 1/3. Are you with me here? So it won't be 1/5. but 1/3, it should be 1/3. So out of three examples, one has glitter, yes, so it is 1/3. So this is what how dependent variables work. So when you say that given, it is given that gold is yes, right? This is how we read probability of glitter is equal to yes, given that gold is yes. So you are given that gold is yes. So look at only those examples where gold is yes. And out of those examples, find out the one where glitter is also yes. But the point is, the question I made was, we need to know this to make prediction. And how do we know this? We know this by learning from the data. We need to learn these probability values from data. Kaushal is saying y is equal to mu next is just in y. Okay. No. Last probability means posterior. Okay. We'll reach there, Kaushal. Don't worry. Don't try to think the next level. Let's first focus here. More or less, you are right. But we'll reach there. So we need to learn these probabilities from the data, and the kind of things that we learn from data is called model parameters. So if I ask you what are the model parameters for naive-Bayes classifier, what would be your answer? Answer is already there here on this slide, but still just I want to confirm it. What are the model parameters of naive-Bayes classifier? She says likelihood parameter. Perfect. Yes. So these are the model parameters. So now on, remember that every machine learning model has model parameters, and these model parameters are the quantities that you learn from the data. For example, in case of linear regression, the model parameters are linear equations parameter, coefficient of the variable W1, W2, W3, and so on. In case of naive-Bayes classifier or Bayesian network, model parameters are the probability values that we want to learn. So likelihood, prior, and class predictor. Great. Even denominator we can remove, but that we'll see, we'll discuss about that a bit later. So let's see. So this, if you want to solve this problem with naive-Bayes classifier, our model has three parameters. The first parameter is class prior. Second is actually, there are two possible combinations. And third parameter is So we are ignoring the denominator for the time being, and we are only considering numerator as model parameter. I will come to that. I will tell you why it is so. But these are the model parameters. I'm hearing some noise from outside, so I will just close the window. Meanwhile, you just calculate this probability value. Okay, so can anyone answer this value? Some we have already calculated, I guess. So gold is equal to, yes, we have calculated. I like blue color. Gold is equal to, yes, was with probability of 3/5. So it means that probability of gold is equal to no is. Two by five, right? So glitter is equal to yes, gold is equal to yes is, what did we calculate? 1/3. So there are three cases where gold is yes, and out of those three cases, in one case the glitter was also yes, so it was 1/3. And there are two cases where gold was no, and in both cases glitter was yes. Wow, so the data is not very reliable, but anyway, this is what we have got. So it is 1. Then golden is equal to yes, given gold is yes. So there are three cases where gold is yes, and out of those three cases, in two cases, it was golden also. So 2/3. And there are two cases where gold was no, and out of those two cases, in one case, it was golden. So it is 1/2. Right? So these are the values we have. And now with this value, we can answer any inference question. So let's say I am asking you a question like, if, yes, or is it gold? If it is, golden, but not glittery. So if I ask you a question like this, what would be your answer? Or before that, what will be the probability formula? The question is that probability of gold is equal to yes given golden is equal to yes, comma, glitter is equal to yes. And this is the question we are asking. And what we know so far is this parameter. So these are the parameters given to us. we can apply Bayes rule, we can fix them and we can get our answer. Let's try that. So once we flip, apply Bayes rule, and what we get is so far, what I have done is I have applied Bayes rule on this formula and flipped the parameters because I have values of golden years given, gold years, glitter years given, glitter years, and so on. Oh, glitter, no. Okay, yes, right. The question was not glitter. Okay, thanks for correcting this. Sari is all with me now, Suti. Okay, good. So, by applying Bayes rule, we have reached here. Okay. Now, let's see what to do with this parameter. So, likelihood here is, let's break down this into three parts, as we know. This part is likelihood, and this part is classifier, and this is predictor pair. So let us see how then we calculate them separately. So classifier is probability of gold is equal to yes. There is simple part. We have answer of this. That is 3/5. Let's talk about the second part. There is predictor prior. So let's call it third part, predictor prior. There is probability of what is the answer for this? What we are looking at here is the joint probability of golden is equal to yes, even glitter is equal to no. And what we know is golden and glitter are independent of each other, but they are dependent on good. So that becomes a bit complicated and unnecessary also, that we'll see eventually. But let's ignore this for a while. Let us ignore this for a while. And the most crucial part of the calculation here is the second part, the probability of even gold is equal to yes. So now how do we calculate this? Again, the question of independence will play a role here. If the golden and glitter are dependent on each other, then we need to discuss joint distribution as we have seen earlier. That is, golden is equal to yes, given glitter no, and gold no, and so on. But if the golden and glitter are independent variables, then we can directly multiply that probability. Same applies for the conditional probability also. So we are assuming that golden and glitter are conditionally independent given gold. Conditionally independent from each other. So if you know that the object is gold, then golden and glitter values are not influencing each other. And that is why this can be simplified, or you can break down this equal to this probability of so you can do it like this and you can calculate. And now these two things you know, right? From our picture set, we have this glitter is no and gold is yes, can be calculated as 2/3. Gold is yes given, golden is yes given, golden yes is 2/3. So that we can calculate as 2/3, and you get the answer of the numerator part. But here we have made an assumption that golden and glitter are independent of each other, given gold, and this assumption is known as naive assumption. And this is from where the classifier gets its name, that naive Bayes classifier. Okay, so this was the intuition and basic formulation of naive Bayes classifier. We'll define it more formally in next lecture. I think it is already time, so I will not take questions here. But please go through it before attending the next lecture, and we'll do some question answers at the beginning of the lecture next time. I will end here with this. Thank you.
हेलो।